in to learn how.
All right, so first, what is a cinemagraph? It's basically a video, sort of like a GIF or a GIF, that's a repeating video where most of the image looks still, and then there's just a certain part of it that is still playing as a video. So here's an example, classic, of a coffee cup with the steam that's continually just rising, and this would go on forever if I let it. Here's another one of a glass of beer being poured where it's not getting full, it's just continuously being filled. And then here's lastly a river that's actually flowing, and it's just going to continuously flow. The funny thing about this one is that no part of this river is moving except for this part that's flowing in the background. So a couple things to think about when you are filming your own videos to create a cinemagraph. One is make sure that it's steady. It's got to be perfectly still. Use a tripod, use stabilization, make sure it's perfectly still. And then second is just make sure you think about the actual motion that's going to happen and what you want to have actually moving in your cinemagraph. Something like this is perfect. Some water flowing, steam rising, something rotating like a fan or a windmill is another great example. Really, you could do anything, but it has to be some sort of motion that can be repeated or looped and look natural. It doesn't have to be a perfect loop, and I'm going to show you how, because of course, like, this river itself is not a loop of water going round and round and round and me just clipping it together. But there's fancy ways to actually fade it together so it looks seamless. So let's get into Premiere Pro to show you how to do it. But basically, this is what your sequence is going to end up looking like. So I'm going to recreate this from scratch. It's the same process for any of these videos. I'm just using the river as an example. So first, I'm going to drop this river clip into a new sequence. All of these videos I'm using are from pexels.com, a great place for free videos and photos. I don't work for them. I don't make money from them. It's just a great source of free content to use. Next, I'm just going to create a sort of 4-second clip. So I'm going to actually drag in the end of this video clip to around 4 seconds because I just don't need more than that to work with. Next, I'm going to create 2 layers. One is the video layer, one is the still layer. So to easily duplicate the video layer here, I'm just going to hold the Option key down. I'm on a Mac, so on a PC, that'd be the Alt key, and just click and drag up to the second layer. So I clicked and dragged that video track from track 1 to track 2, and it creates a duplicate. Otherwise, you could copy and paste, but just make sure they're one on top of the other. Now I'm going to turn off this top one for now, and I'm just going to scrub through until there's a point where I think it would look good as a still image. For this river clip, it really doesn't matter, but sometimes it matters. For example, in the coffee cup or in the filling up the glass with beer one, I didn't want the beer to be too high or too low. Something like this was perfect. And then same with the coffee cup. There were moments where the steam was actually spilling over the edges of the coffee cup. I didn't want a moment like that. I wanted one where the steam was just right above the coffee mug. So for this clip, it really doesn't matter, but move your time indicator or the playhead right here to wherever you want it to be still. Then with the video track clip on the first track selected, right click it and choose frame hold options. Then drop down the drop down here and choose playhead and make sure hold on is checked because it's going to create a hold or a freeze frame basically where the playhead is and click OK. Now if I play through this, it's completely still. All right, so now let me turn on the top layer, and for the sake of visualizing, I'm going to turn off the bottom layer. And now I want to just mask out the area that is being that's actually going to be moving. So I don't want the whole thing. I just want this part of the river, or maybe I do just want this part down here. It's up to you to decide. Now with this top layer selected, make sure it's selected. Click the effects controls window up here or wherever it is. Go to window effects controls if you don't see it. Then under opacity, click the free draw bezier, which is basically a mask tool. Again, make sure you have the video layer selected, not the still one. Next, with this tool, go to your program window and just click and click around and create a mask around the animated or the video part of your scene. Notice that when I sort of connected the dots and created this somewhat trapezoidal rectangle, it now creates this little mask. To blend it in better to the still image, increase the feathering in the settings under opacity so that it sort of blends the edges a bit more. So if I play through this, that looks pretty good. Now if I turn on the bottom layer and play through it, looks pretty good. Now we just have to loop it and then export it. So one thing first for playback in Premiere Pro to loop, there is a loop playback button. If you click this plus button down here, you can customize the buttons that you have down here below your program window. Make sure that you have the loop button. Just drag it and drop it down here so that if you set in and out points down here on your timeline, actually, it actually will play and loop through it. So if I don't have it on, it's not going to play loop. If I do have it on, it loops, and that helps you to see how it is actually going to look. All right, so how do we actually loop this video? Because the end of this clip, if it cuts from one to the other, it doesn't look good. So if I play through this, you see that cut right there. So what I actually want is the end of this clip to basically match up with the start of the clip. How can I do that? Here's a quick way. Take the razor blade tool, which is C on your keyboard for most people, or if you click the razor tool over here in your tools, and go around 1 second and make a cut. Now, with your selection tool, V on your keyboard, take this first part and drag it up to the third track over to the end. So now what you'll notice is this part, which is now the new start of our video, which I'm going to set as the start by pressing I on my keyboard to set the endpoint for this timeline or sequence, this start matches up with this end, right? What about this part right here in the middle? Because there's still a cut or a jump right there. Here's where we create a fade. There's a couple ways you can do it, but the easiest is just right-clicking and choosing Apply Default Transition, or just selecting the end and pressing Command D on a Mac or Control D if you're on a PC. Now this creates a fade or a cross dissolve that I would extend all the way to the end. So if you play through it now and loop through it, it fades, and because this is flowing water and it's hard to see the details, it looks perfect. It looks like it's continually flowing. Now, if you are doing this for another type of video, you might have to play with where that cut is. You might have to adjust the start and the end point of your video and move things around or move the mask around. This one was a very easy one to create a loopable video just because the water is flowing and it's just an easy thing to do. So you might have to play around with it a bit, adjusting where it starts and where it ends. So I just clicked this and used the very first 4 seconds of this video, and that tended to work for me. But maybe for you, you might have to find a part in your video to work with that's seconds 10 through 13 or 11 through 19 or 8 through 10. Sometimes shorter is better, sometimes longer is better. You're gonna have to figure that out for your own video. All right, so now how do we export this as an animated GIF so that we can upload it online as a photo and have it continuously play when we share it? Just go export it by pressing Command M or Control M if you're on a PC, and that's going to bring up your output settings. Under Format, select Animated GIF. There should be a preset that's selected called Animated GIF. I am using the latest version of Premiere Pro right now. It's the 2018 version, one of the newer 2018 versions, and they've had this animated GIF option in many of the latest versions of CC. The one thing I do say to change is this size right here. The video clip I'm using is 1280 by 720, which is actually pretty good, but one thing with animated GIFs is that, or GIFs, however you pronounce it, is that they get really large, they have very large file size if you have a large actual image. So choosing something like 700 or something might be good. Make sure that the constrained proportion or the aspect ratio is locked here so that the height changes if you change the width. See how if I change that to 1000 or 700, oops, not 7000, I want 700, that changes with it. All right, so now you can, if you choose where you want to save it, we're going to just save this to my river, my Cinemagraphs. Now I can just export it straight from Premiere Pro, or you can send it to Adobe Media Encoder. And now this is being saved. And we have our new River 2 GIF that I just created right within Premiere Pro. So you don't even have to use After Effects. You can do this all right within Premiere Pro. All right, so that's how you create a Cinemagraph in Premiere Pro from start to finish. If you have any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure you give it a thumbs up, a like, a comment, and you subscribe to our channel for more tutorials like this one. Well, I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, please like and subscribe to the channel for more. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below in the comments. And if you're looking to take your skills to the next level, make sure you head over to videoschoolonline.com, where we have premium courses, more free tutorials and articles, guides, and all kinds of stuff that will help you become a better creator. Thanks so much for watching, and have a beautiful day.